Hi guys, this is Saurav. In this video, we will learn how we can create Ninja Fruit Catching Game in MIT App Inventor. So you can see that's our game here, right? And that's the first screen of our game. So we need to click on just play button and your game will start. And you can see that's the amazing button design. There's some background design, right? So let's click on this play button. And here you can see that's Ninja and that's fruit. You have to catch all these fruits, right? And whenever you catch fruit, your score will increase. Here you can see 3. And you will get some bonus score also. So whenever fruits will collide with each other, then we will get some bonus point. Okay? So here you can see whenever both this will collide, so you will get some bonus. Now you have to catch. And here you can see we have 3 life. Here you can see 3 heart, right? So now let me just let it go, this banana. And here you can see we remaining 2 lives. If I will just catch this one and let it go about this. And you can see we have only 1 life right now. And just let it go, this one fruit also. Then game will over. And you will find here is score and see, you can see game over the screen and your score is 22 and you can restart your game by pressing this button, right? So that's the second part of this game, okay? So in the last tutorial, we have learned how we can design this game, okay? So make sure you have to watch first video and then you can watch this video. This video is all about how we can code for this game, okay? So let's go to the block section. We have done this one. So whenever someone click on start image, then we have to disable, it means hide the first layout, and we have to display main layout of our game. So go to the design, visible off to this start LY, and this main LY should be visible. So that's the design, okay? Go to the block section, and now we have to create variables here, global variables, okay? So for why we are creating variable, we have to create variable for speed. For all these fruits, okay? So go to the block and let's click on variable and you will see initialize global, and we have to add here some name. So I'm going to make it speed 1 like this, and I'm going to assign this value to 1, okay? You can change the speed also, right? So that really doesn't matter. So I'm going to copy and paste 3 times, 4 times, and then I'm going to make it speed 2, speed 3, and speed 1, 2, and 3. Fine. Let me just change all these speeds. So 1, 3, and this one is 4. Right. Now we have to create one more variable for health. Okay. Go to the design. Here you can see we have 3 lives, right? So we have to check this condition for game over. So let's create one more variable for its name is just like HP health. Okay, and this one is value should be 3. This should be static, okay? It means this should be 3 because we are using a 3 life, right? Now let's whenever someone click on this play button, right, it means this start image button. So we have to disable and enable this main LY true and start LY should be false, but we have to start the game also. It means this should be falling down like this, okay? So how we can start this game? So go to the block and we will create one procedure here, okay? So we are not going to put every code in this button. So we will create one procedure. Click on procedure and you can see here procedure option, right? So, and I'm going to rename this procedure name to start game, right? That's our procedure name. Now in this procedure, we will call set image sprite. It means this one. This one is image sprite 2. This one is image sprite 3 and this one is image sprite 2. It means 2, 3 and 4 speed. Click on image sprite 2 and that one is dot speed. Set image sprite 2 dot speed should be get speed 1 data global value like this, and then just copy and paste again and again 3 times, okay? And image sprite 3, make this one image sprite 4, global speed should be 2 and this one global speed 3 like this, right? Now we have to use one more thing. We have to move all these image spread in the down position here, right? So how we can do this? So we have to use here heading option. So simple, just copy and paste this image spread here, and you have to change this speed option to heading. You will find heading here. Now delete this, and here we need to copy this number value, paste it here, like make it here, and this should be minus 90, right? Because we have to move it in this position, you know, minus, right? So I'm going to copy and paste two times and make it image spread 2, 3, and 4. So this should be 2, this should be 3, and this one is 4, like this, right? Now we have to call this procedure. So whenever someone click on this start img, it means start game button. So we will call this procedure also. So you will find click on procedure here, you can see call start game. Okay, so just call it here. So we will make it as a false, then this one main visible true, and we will call this procedure for starting game, right? Now go to the design, and here you can see this two buttons. We have to move our ninja, right? So for that we have to just change the x value. We have to increase the x value and we have to decrease the x value. So for that, just go to the design and click on this button. Here you can see button 2, and click on this button 3. It means on button 2 click. Where is this one? Button 2 click. This one, button 2 click. So I'm going to make it here. So where we have to move this on button 2 click, click on this button. This one is 3 and this one is. So let me just where this one image or main image spread, where is this? This one, just make it here, and here you can see the x value is 29. If I just move it here, it means x value is 114, right? So whenever someone click on this image button 3, so we have to increase the x value, right? It means button 3, whenever someone click on button 3, so we have to increase x value. So click on math and we'll find the option of plus, this one, and image 1, this one, set image spread dot x 2, this should be, and just make it here, and we will increase it by 10. Drag and draw this value here, and we have to get the current value also. So click on image spread and you find image spread dot x, like this, and just copy and paste it and change it to 2. And make this one, okay, we have to remove this block, delete this block, and click on the maths, and we have to minus our x value to move in the left, right? So we have to get the current x value of image spread 1. This is our robot, right? And we have to minus by 10. Go to the design, you can see image spread 1. This is a robot, right? So now this one is fine, game is start, we can move our robot now. Now we need to use here some game over, how we can make it game over, okay, and how we can increase the score, right? So first, whenever image spread 2 collide with, okay, so whenever all these images collide with, so it means go to the design and let me just check which image. It means this image 2, 3, and 4, right? So whenever image spread 2 dot collide with, okay, if this one is collide with anything, then we will move it to the position in the top, right? It means this one collide with this one image spread, right? So we will move it back to here, like, so go to the block, so it will look like there are a lot of fruits, they are coming from the sky, like this, okay? So go to the block, and here we need to code move function. So image spread 2 you will find here, and you will see here move option, call move, this one, and we have to move it in the random position, right? We cannot we are not getting it from the same position. This should be like here, right? So we have to change the x value and this should be random, but y value should be static. Okay, so go to the blog and we will use your maths, click on, and you will see a random value option, random integer from. So we will use it from, go to the design. You can see the x value right now is 94. If this one is 62 and this one is 224, so 62, so this value should be 62, 224 value, and y value should be in the top. It means this should be 2 always. Fine. Now we have to call here a score option, right? We have to increase the score. So whenever this our ninja catch the any fruit like this, okay, so we have to increase our score. So how we can do this? So we will call here one procedure, okay, because we have to repeat this score increase option in 3 times. It means whenever collide this image collide with this one banana, this one watermelon, and this one, then we have to increase the score. So we will not call it again and again. So that's why we are using one more procedure here. So click on this procedure option and just drag and drop it here, and we will call it as a total score, right? Like this. This one is our procedure. Okay, now how we can call this total procedure? So we have to increase score. It means go to the design, click on this label, it means label 1. So go to the block and you will find your label 1 option, and you can see label 1 dot text, this one. So whenever someone call this total procedure, the label 1 dot text should be increased. So call this one maths function to increase value, drag and drop it here, remove this image spread 1 dot text value, make it 1. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm minus here, this should be plus. Okay, so drag and drop it here, delete this one, delete this one, and this should be 1, and we have to get the current label 1 dot text value, this one. Now current value is 0, then whenever someone collide, so we have, let me just call it, okay, first call on procedure, and you can see it's total score, and we will call it here, right? It means whenever image spread collide with the ninja, then we will call, we will move it to the top, and we will call total score. So whenever this will call total score, so what will happen? Set label 1 dot text value, it means right now value is 0, so label 1 dot 0 plus 1, it means z 1. So this will increase the label value, it means the score value, right? So tomorrow we will learn how we can make our game over and how we can code for restart button. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Please like my video, subscribe my channel, share this video. Have a nice day, be safe, bye bye.